Hello guys, good morning. Today the topic is modal verbs. Okay. That means the modal verbs is a verb used with another verb to express an idea such as possibility that is not expressed by the main verb. Okay, the modal verbs in English are can, could, may, might, must, ought, should, will, and would. Okay? Okay, the structure in modal verbs is can, could, must, have to, should, would, will, and shall. Okay? Remember, this structure is in affirmative. Okay? Affirmative in modal verbs. In negative, it's possible to say can't, couldn't, mustn't, don't have to, shouldn't, wouldn't, and won't. Okay? Please take into account this information according to the modal verbs. And what is the usage? The usage is, pay attention, can and could. Okay? Can express ability, possibility, permission, request, offer, and cannot. Okay? And could express ability in the past, possibility in the past, permission in polite form, request in polite form, suggestions, and conditional of can't. And what does that mean? Or what is the meaning? Ability. Look at example. I can speak four languages. Juliana can speak three languages. Ardila can swim for 3 hours. Barón can write a lot of poems. Okay? Something like that. Impossibility. Alcohol can use cancer. Yes? In permission, look at example. Can I use your book, please? Can I borrow your dictionary, please? In request, can you make me coffee? In offer, can I help you? And cannot, you cannot smoke here. Okay? Please, pay attention. El verbo modal can puede expresar lo siguiente: habilidad para lograr hacer algo. ¿Ok? Fíjense en el ejemplo que les estoy mostrando. El can es usado para el tiempo en presente, mientras que el could lo utilizamos para el pasado. ¿Ok? Ok, now, continue. Good. Look at the example. He could play football when he was a kid. Aquí. Possibility. A lot of crime could be prevented. Permission. Could I take your book, please? In request. Could you lend me this book? Suggestion. I could help you with English. I could help you with Spanish. Okay? Unconditional of can. If you called me, I couldn't find you some suggestion. Okay? Please, pay attention. Look at and take this information in your notebooks. Okay? It's so very important. And you have it. Okay? Next. The modal verbs, must and should, okay? We use must to talk about obligation and prohibition. And we use should to give advice, okay? It's possible to say should or shouldn't, okay? Please. Read it, be careful, this information, okay? For example, when you speak about the obligation things, it's possible you say must, okay? Look at example, I must do my homework, and mustn't is prohibition. You mustn't walk on the grass in the park, okay? Oh. Si queremos decir una obligación 100% sí o sí, podemos utilizar el must. Pero si lo vamos a prohibir, vamos a prohibir algo como tal, podemos utilizar el mustn't. Got it? Now, should. When I speak about advice, it's about the consejo, ¿cierto? Si queremos dar un consejo afirmativo, lo podemos decir utilizando el should. Look at example. You should eat healthy food. It's good for you. O shouldn't, si lo queremos negar. You shouldn't stay up till late. It's bad for you. ¿Cierto? Ahí lo estamos haciendo en de forma negativa. ¿Ok? Another, will and would, okay? Will is when you express request, refusal, offers, and would express request formal, refusal in past, and habit in past, okay? Please. Take into account. Will lo usamos para un tiempo en futuro de manera informal. También podemos hacer una solicitud utilizando el will. ¿Okay? Como nos ilustra la imagen. O emplear el would para referirnos a una solicitud o algún hábito hacia el pasado, okay? So look at example, request. Will you help me file this paper? Would you please turn on the light? We won't share his potato chips with me. I wouldn't eat vegetable as a child. I help you carry your groceries. And I would like to work almost every day. Okay? Please, be careful. Utilizamos el will para referirnos de manera informal hacia un futuro. Okay? Y el would ya es más formalito para expresar hábitos o solicitudes en el pasado. ¿Vale? So, another one. May and my. May is when you express higher possibility. Okay? It's the same, but may is 90%. And might is 80%. Okay? Look at. May is possible. Is possible when you speak about possibility, permission, okay, request, and wish. And might is the same, but is more formal. Got it? Look at examples. For example, she may be at home. He might like playing basketball. May I sit here? May I ask you a question? Yes. You may go now. You might try me cheesecake. May I have the bill, please? Might I borrow your book? May you both be very happy. If you work it hard, you might finish it. Okay? Please read it carefully and analyze the situation using my and may. Okay? Next modal verbs is have to or don't have to. Okay? Have to is something you need to do following a rule. And don't have to is something which is not necessary. Got it? El have to traduce como tener que. Y el don't have to es como no tener que. ¿Cierto? Como nos ilustra, como nos muestra, como tal, para que utilizamos el have to y el don't have to. Cuando necesitamos seguir algo, o como seguir un parámetro de una ruta, de una regla, perdón, regla, podemos utilizar el have to. Pero si algo no es necesario hacerlo, podemos poner el don't have to. ¿Ok? So, look at example. You have to clean your room every day if you want to use the computer. My sister has to eat some chocolate before going to bed. Where do we have to buy the tickets for the concert? And don't have to. I don't have to go to school today. It's Friday. You don't have to wear a long dress to go to the party. He doesn't have to buy me a present. It is not necessary. Okay? And these modal verbs show today is not possible to say, but it's very important to have or notice this modal verb. Okay? So this modal verb, I'm going to explain you for the next class, okay? And finally, activity, of course. It's the same activity, okay? You have the workshop through Google Forms, and that's it for today. Got it? So thank you so much, guys. See you next class. If you have any questions, let me know for the next class. Okay, goodbye, God bless you. Thank you so much. I never knew you were,